sidestepping Congress as he launches some stimulus programs for underwater mortgages and forgiveness of student loans. He says Congress is dysfunctional and, quote, we can't wait. I can wait. But let's go to our guests to see where they are. We have Peter Welch, Democrat from Vermont, David Schweikert, Republican from Arizona. Welcome back, gentlemen. David Schweikert, let me just ask you, look, these refis of underwater mortgages and what's probably going to be some forgiveness or forbearance of student loans, these are huge sums of money that will affect the government's financial position and taxpayers. Why shouldn't they be run through the normal oversight committees? I don't understand.
Well, and you're hitting the unknown right now, as we don't know in what we're reading, is there principal write-down involved in this? I don't think there is. Are these going to be loans that sit on the portfolios of Fannie and Freddie? This is truly one of those occasions where we're worried about the devil being in the details.
Yes, well, so, Peter Welch, these are taxpayer issues. I mean, Fannie and Freddie is wholly owned by the U.S. government. Student loans have been an enormous growing problem, the default rate on student loans. If that is going to be accelerated or forbearance and the government revenues are going to come in short, Peter, this is a taxpayer issue. This is a government banking issue. Shouldn't it run through your committees?
It probably should, but here's the issue. Number one, the president is not going to be able to do anything that he doesn't have the legal authority to do. And whatever any of us can do to get us out of this recession, ideally we do it together, but what we can do individually as a Congress or as the president, as long as it's within legal authority to do it, I say let's do what we can, ideally together, but separately if that's what it takes to get us out of this recession. It has to be within the bounds of law, so anything that deviates beyond that, the president won't have the ability to do.
Well, I think there's oversight functions left and right. These are huge financial sums going on here.
That's right, and we can exercise that oversight function, and we should.
Yeah, but before the fact, not after the fact.
Well, there's two questions, Larry. One is the president acting within his legal authority? If he is, he can do that. If he isn't, then the courts can stop him. But whether he is or not, the oversight function, you're right, we should be exercising that.
Dave Schweikert, I mean, you don't have to take a pro or con position on this stuff. I'm just calling for oversight. What does President Obama mean when he says Congress is dysfunctional? Is that a political charge? Is that a Republican slur? What's he talking about?
Look, we're already in election season. I expect to hear lots of different slurs, so yeah, let it come. Look, I sit on the Financial Services Committee. I sit on the subcommittee that actually watches over Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Look, if it's truly just a path to do refinancing, maybe that authority sits out there. It's already legal, it's mechanical, and we have the obligation to watch it and make sure costs aren't being pushed back on the taxpayers. Our fear is, are we creating some sort of artificial wave where we're forcing payoffs on bonds that shouldn't be happening? Are we doing a transfer of risk? So those are the details, and they're just not out yet, that we got to get our head around.
And, okay, well put. And Peter Welch, what about forbearing or forgiving student loans? We are in hock. I know the students are in hock, but the government is in hock to this massive factory of creating student loans down through the years. Now, this has to be an oversight issue also. Obama's going to say something about it tomorrow or the next day.
Well, it definitely is an oversight issue, but there's two issues, whether it's student loans or mortgages. You've got some folks who are performing, but they're paying 6 or 7% interest and they're locked in. And I think David and I agree that if you can write that down to the record low, historical low rates of 4%, you're going to help that homeowner, you're going to help that student.
Right.
The question of write down in principle is another question,
controversial. We're flat out of time. I got
Thanks,
so
Larry.
Into it. Anyway, Peter Welch, thank you. David.